What's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel. I am Mr. Gilly, and this is the third episode of Space Engineers. Now, in this episode, we're going to add a connector on top of this exploration ship, and we're going to find a nice area where we can add another connector to our base so that we can recharge the battery. And after that, we're gonna go exploring. So I have already checked out the ship, and we have a cargo container right there. We can make the exploration ship, we can make it hang out somewhere here. But I was also looking at the there should be a this thing, the conveyor, right in the corner. Maybe, just maybe, we can remove this right here. And make an opening right here. Now, what I want to do is, I want to make a connector that sits on top and connects the ship from above, because we have a connector on top of the ship as well. So let's remove this so that we can add a little platform to walk on, so that we don't have to use our thruster the whole time. Now let's go in our inventory. Let's grab the the tubes. There they are, the curved conveyor tubes, so that we can connect, we make a connection that goes outside. Okay, there we go. And we have to aim one down, and on top of that we're going to make a connector. I'm gonna hang a connector on below it right here. And it should probably work. Probably. And then we're gonna add a connector on top of the ship. And we can connect it like a hovering craft. It should magnet, like click it, make it stay. So even if the ship is off, it shouldn't just drop down the ship. But let's make a platform underneath the ship just in case it makes the ship drop. And yeah, that's my plan for now. So let's grind this up. I mean, let's weld it up. Grinding up is not the right choice of words. So I need a lot of steel tube and motors. Construction components. And yeah. Let's see. Small steel tube. Need some motors. We need computer, construction components. There we go. That should do it. Should do the trick. Let's check this one out. Construction component and steel tubes are finished. Right, so what's this doing here? The flight seat, we don't really need it. We can add a control station instead. And while we're at it, might as well remove these slopes. Because right now this platform has no function at all. I have enabled autosave on this game because the game keeps on crashing. And without autosave, I have to start over from scratch. And I've had to do that a couple of times, which is really annoying. Wow, what? Okay, alright, no problem. I hope it doesn't damage anything. No, not a good idea. Uh-oh. Oh crap. Oh. Alright, so we got that. There we go. So we might add one of those, the panels, to there. Let's do that. We have some, right? Number 4. Catwalk. Why doesn't this want to work? Well, I decided it will work. Okay, it seems to work like this. So let's add the control station. Facing the beautiful view, obviously. All right, so we need 6 more display. There should be some display. Oh, that is a lot of display, more than I need. Alright, so is the sun up yet? Yeah, there it is. I was wrong. I cannot keep track of this sun. The first day it came up somewhere there, then it goes down somewhere there, then it goes up somewhere there. It's like random or something. Right, so what is awesome? We're going to rotate our solar array to face towards the sun. Let's see. Solar array rotor. There we go. And now it's fully facing the sun, and look at what a beautiful way. It is 4 bars on every solar, and what I'm wondering, they're having output, but they're not doing anything, which means that no one needs that energy. So I'm going, this one is on recharge. Stored power is fully recharged. This one is off. That's weird. I'm gonna put that on recharge as well. And this is also off. Why are the batteries off? Semi-auto and semi-auto. So right now, we should have, no, they're not doing anything yet. This is confusing. This is recharging. And it's full. This is recharging, and it's going to become full soon. We have a small reactor which is off. That's good. Semi-auto. I'm just gonna make them recharge.
No station fuel.
All of them recharge, and now we are getting energy from the solar panel. Right. So the solar panels are now actually funding the station with energy. Not a lot, and we have set all the batteries on recharge, which means that all the excess energy will go into the batteries, and that's pretty sweet. So let's see, we don't need this. Oops. Right, so we have to fix the connector over here. Construction components and small steel tube. We need a lot of steel tubes. So let's go down, check out our inventory. Steel tubes 11, that's not gonna be enough. We need construction components. Display, do we need, no, we don't need that. Right, so do we need computer as well? We'll see. So we need 10 small steel tube. Now I'm running out of small steel tube, and I need another connector on that, but I know that it won't require as much steel tubes as this thing, but still we have to find something that we can break. This has 12, but I really don't want to break that. I think I'm going to, this is the air vent, which is making oxygen, providing oxygen for the oxygen generator. This is hard. See, I have my hydrogen tank. Oxygen generator needs ice, I guess, to make oxygen and hydrogen. But I don't know what the function of this thing. Oh, this thing just creates oxygen within this ship. But it is not needed anymore because we needed it when we were high, and when we were in the outer circle of the Earth. That's when we needed the oxygen. Well, we don't need it now because there's plenty of oxygen here. So this has 20 small steel tubes. Nuclear reactor is not turned on, so there's no loss here at all. What's that? Another conveyor, I think. Yeah, so let's fix this up. There we go. Right. So do we need to add some settings for it? Let's see, where is it? Connector. I'm gonna call it yeah, well, I don't know if that had much sense throughout. Or collect on all. I think it should collect all. No, we'll see. We'll do it manually because sometimes maybe I would like to store my tools and whatnot in there. I don't want the base to suck everything up. Right, so I see that I have some damage on my health. Took care of that. I will probably need... I don't need an oxygen bottle. I would much rather have a hydrogen bottle. In case I run out of hydrogen. Right, so let's add a connector on this baby. There we go, let's save the game. I don't trust the autosave. So, I'm doing it manually. There we have, it only needed 6 steel tubes. So, I think the ship was already functioning. We already took it for a small test flight. So let's see if we can switch it on, lights off, release.
Ship fuel low.
Stop complaining.
Ship fuel low.
Now look, now it's auto saving. Let's get out. Let's keep it hovering for a while and remove this. And this should probably in the way as well. Alright.
Ship fuel low.
I know. Ooh, that was rough. Connected.
No fuel.
Alright, obviously, because those batteries in the in the base were sucking all the energy, and now this one is getting depleted. So I want this for recharge, right? I don't want it to spend energy, I want it to suck energy. So let's see, what are the solar panels doing? Current outputs, they're all busy working. This one is stored power max. Yeah, so this one is discharge. This one can go discharge, and solar panels are still feeding something, so discharge on this one as well. Right, so now the solar panels are not doing anything, so this one should be charging. I'm gonna give it a fashionable name. Why is it doing what? No recharge. Right, so now it's getting megawatts, it's getting input from the batteries in the ship or the solar panels. Solar panels are still outputting energy and fully recharged in 15 minutes. Great. So, can we shut down the ship? No, we can't. No problem, because we're getting charged all the fuel that we're wasting now. We don't even have to keep it hovering, it's connected, so this gives us a good opportunity to fix the rest. But let's add a fail safe in case anything goes wrong. We have a small platform here to keep us from crashing into the soil. There we go. Great. So this is good, guys. Let me just save the game. Can't be too careful. Awesome. So that is our little exploration ship, which is currently refueling. In the meantime, what can we do in the meantime? We can remove this. Let's see. And make a little path to our ship. Always tricky, this thing. Oh, I just had it. Don't know why I did that. Problem is, I don't know which is which. There we go. I guess that's it. So now, when we want to get into our beautiful exploration ship, we get in from here. We want to get out from here. Could weld that up. Not gonna do that because we don't have any ores. We don't have any material. No minerals, nothing. Just the ship and all the components that we can grab from the ship. Yeah. So let's see. This actually looks good. We didn't weld this up, but it's nice transparent thing. I can see that battery is at 3. That battery is not doing much, I guess. Battery. It's not doing anything, or it's outputting. Alright, so Explorer battery is 30% charged. It has a capacity of 1 megawatts and it has 300 kilowatts per hour. 9 more minutes until it's fully charged. Let's see, maybe we should put back some of the glass in here. And here. Not sure though. How is the sun doing? Sun is over there. Solar panels are still correct. Alright, I guess it takes a while. However, I think there's only like a small, you can't just, this thing is recharging really slow. And I know it has, we have a whole battery. A battery in the base has 3 times the capacity of this one, and we have batteries in there which are full, at least 2 of them. So if we want, if the game would allow us, we could have instantly charged this battery. But I guess there's a charge limit ratio, or maybe because the ship is on. The fuel, I can see that the thrusters are doing something. Is there no way to shut them off? It can't recharge faster? Alright, so it's becoming to go halfway. Alright, that's good. I think for now, you know, I think this is good. Actually, let's weld this up right here. Right, I think we should add more feet, whatever you call them, landing gear. Perhaps we could add wheels, but I think they're too heavy. How heavy is this? Landing gear is it doesn't say. How much max mass? All right, doesn't matter. We're gonna add landing gear right here. There looks a bit weird though, but we don't want this to land and the ass of the ship to hit the ground, so let's weld this up. We have all the material. This is small landing gear, doesn't take a lot of materials, which is great. You know, when we find uranium, we can always add a reactor on the ship that can fuel the battery in case it's gonna get down. I can't wait anymore, actually. Let's just go.
No fuel.
So I'm going to control all the batteries. I'm going to set this. Thing is, I want to set the batteries to recharge.
No fuel.
But I don't want them to grab energy. All the batteries in here are recharging.
No fuel.
What if I set them all to discharge? Will it go faster? Yeah, it will go a lot faster. It won't go that fast. The current input is 4.0 megawatts. Maximum stored power is 1. But still the stored power is charging very slow. So I don't think it matters. I'm going to set all of these to recharge. One battery can go to semi-auto. And these are still doing their outputs. This one can go to semi-auto. Actually removing charge now, so disconnect. Alright. Let's climb to the ground, shut the thing off. Oops. Wrong key. Oh, the dampeners were on. Was that it? Let's check out if everything is still going alright in the ship. I'm gonna add a little control panel here, so that I don't have to walk all the way to the control seats. Sorry. Yeah, because that's a pain. Control station is what I meant. Yeah, let's see. Are the solar panels still doing some output? Yes, they are. Batteries are charging. That's great. This one can go on recharge as well. Everything should run on the solar panels. The beacon, I don't want it on 10 kilometers. That's too much. We're gonna go exploring probably maximum of 3 kilometers. So the solar panel should account for that. fuel. Yeah, their solar panels are giving a lot of kilowatts, and this just needs 500 watts. So, we can add it to 4. Yeah, this is enough. Let's set the solar panels one more time. Alright, the problem is you cannot see outside of the base with that thing. And the sun has moved and the solar arrays have dropped. All of them have dropped one thingy. So let's just turn it back. Turn it towards the sun. There we go. In fact, I'm gonna turn them a little bit further than this, so that yeah, so that when the sun is it's moving a little bit ahead of the sun, I noticed that I didn't put these ones in the right position. Anyway, let's go. It's time to go. We've been here for a long time. Too long, if you ask me. It's time to get exploring. Get into the ship. Systems on. We've got enough fuel for a while. Landing gear is unlocked.
Ship fuel low.
Stop complaining. So if we had a ooh, that's a fast drop. If we had a crawler, we would crawl probably very slow. And wouldn't be able to crawl on areas like this, which kind of sucks. But with this thing, we can fly as fast as we want, really fast. It's on 100 right now. We're gonna disable inertia dampers so that I can maintain my speed and I only have to push the ship up. So what are we gonna looking for? Well, let's look for some iron ingots, shall we? Inertia dampers off. I remember that I had some coordinates. I'm gonna switch them. I'm gonna do show on HUD. Iron. We found some iron. So, where are they? They are. Oh, they're pretty. Iron's right there.
Ship fuel,
actually, now that I look at it, 2 kilometers is not a lot. It's not even across the lake. But for exploring's sake, let's go somewhere else. Autosave, nice. Stop complaining. I feel like I'm in a helicopter. All right, let's check out this area. Come on. Oh, that was close. Inertia dampers on. That's all right. Let's check out this. There's a big rock over there, so that's gonna be our first ore. We found some silicon as well. Let's check out what this is. Silver, nice. We can always use silver. Oh, come on, stop complaining.
Ship fuel low.
There we go. Oh my god, you cannot believe what just happened. I forgot my drill. Oh man. Let's go back to base.
Ship fuel low.
Flying like this is like, oh crap. On. This is pretty awesome. I feel like I'm in a helicopter. Look at the fuel time. It's 2 hours.
Ship fuel low.
Not anymore.
Ship fuel low. 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 Ship fuel low.
That is really annoying. Let's put on the dampeners.
Ship fuel low. Ship fuel low.
Please die.
Ship fuel low.
Alright, so let's rush inside.
Ship fuel low.
Get our
ship
our
fuel
drill.
Low.
There we go. What are all these things doing in here? Alright, let's go now. Now for real. Ooh, did you see that? That was nice. Alright, where are we going, guys?
Ship fuel low.
That is really annoying.
Ship fuel low.
We can probably get really high with this plane, with this ship. And then we can find valleys and also do that. And dark patches and whatever. There are some over there. Let's go there.
Ship fuel low.
It's a dark patch over here, so there must be something here, right?
Ship fuel low.
Or is this just a shadow? I think this is just a shadow or something. Or is this the biome-ish? That's okay, we're gonna keep it low. We can keep it steady.
Ship fuel low. Ship fuel low. Ship fuel low. Ship fuel low. Ship fuel low.
That must be switched off.
Ship fuel low. Ship fuel low.
So is there nothing here? There's just snow here or something?
Ship fuel low.
I guess we start drilling where we found iron. But we have a nice flight with this thing.
Ship fuel low. Ship fuel low. Ship fuel low. Ship fuel low.
Oh, flying without the inertia is awesome.
Ship fuel low.
Oh, the iron, I think it's just that rock.
Ship fuel low.
Iron, right here. Ice.
Low.
Oh, duh, there's ice. Let's check out the iron
ship
right here.
Low.
It is only some sort of
ship fuel low.
I think it's right underneath here. Yeah, 20 meters down.
Ship fuel low.
Okay. Right there. But what's that though? Ah, I'm too far. Let's drill. Oh, there's ice. I can always use ice. Yeah, we're gonna get some iron, people. Iron is always good. Alright, we're here. Oh, what happened? I hurt myself. Oh no, it's just red stuff. Alright, time to switch on the light. There we go, guys, we found our first iron. Wow, and this is all ice, right? Wow, that's pretty sweet. Ooh, that's a big one. That's pretty sweet. Reel it up. I'm not sure how much iron is in here, but we should probably make some sweet awesome drilling site right here in the next let's play. That is going to be super sweet. We're gonna have like a big drill right here or some expedition thing going on. That's gonna be sweet. Ah, that's a shame. Probably have a lot of stone. Just picked up another one of those stones. Nice. So, let's get out of here. It's a good thing we have thrusters. Because walking is not... It is so possible up to some extent. Hello. Nice, there's a big hole. Don't drive there with your rover. So let's put our thing to the test. Let's put all the ice in here. And the iron. Let's fly back to our base.
Ship fuel.
See how well it will go. Oh shit. Oh my god. Yeah, don't fly without inertia. I almost crashed one of those solar panels or the ship.
Ship fuel low.
Look, the solar panels are still charging thanks to the that we put them a bit more off. All right.
Ship fuel low.
I wonder how full you can put the meteor.
Ship fuel low.
The medium cargo container though. Maybe we should
ship
put a small one
low.
Because we couldn't carry a medium container full anyway. There we go. We got full.
No fuel.
No fuel, no problem. We have inventory. Okay. Oh, I put it in the connector. That's where I put it. So where is the connector? Right. So let's put it. We have to set the. All right. We were going to do it manually. All right. No problem. So we have our connector somewhere. And we are going to put it in the inventory of our right there. And then we should switch on the refinery. Refinery, there you are. And I think it took it.
No fuel.
And the thing is complaining. Yeah, it's doing something nice. It's complaining about not having enough fuel. let's put our battery
no fuel
on recharge. I should definitely make like a staircase. I think a staircase from there to there would be much more awesome and more practical. Let's see. I think everything is going fine. Yeah. Let's save the game. Just to be sure, guys. And yeah, I think this is a good way to end the third Let's Play, right? Ooh. We had some fun. We almost crashed one of the solar panels by going expert mode. We have some... I think we're gonna make like a drilling site somewhere there. Maybe... Yeah, it's gonna be super sweet, guys. Drilling site station thing. But first we gotta do some manual stuff to get enough to build one of those ships. Or an explorer. Who knows. But anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching this third Let's Play. I hope you enjoyed. I hope that you like what we made here. Let's check it out. We've got a small ship right there. Let's check it out. This is gonna be the screenshot for the video. There we go, guys. It looks awesome, don't you think? Guys, thank you again, and I will see you in the next Let's Play, hopefully. Please give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed, and leave me a comment to say what you like and give me some tips and ideas, and I'll maybe I'll even put them in the Let's Play. I'll probably will. So for now, take care and have a great week. Bye bye.